स्मृतापि करुणातपं करुणया हरन्ती नृणाम् अभंगुर तनुत्विषां वलयिता शतैर्विद्युतां कलिन्दगिरिनन्दिनी तटसुरद्रुमालम्बिनी मदीयमतिचुम्बिनी भवतु कापि कादम्बिनी. इन द वी आर इन द प्रतिभा विचारः. सो प्रतिभा इस काव्यस्य कारणं कविगता केवला प्रतिभा साच काव्य घटना अनुकूल शब्दार्थ उपस्थितिः. सो दिस इज द प्रसंगः दैट वी आर लुकिंग एट एंड प्रतिभात्वं च कवितायाः कारणता इट्स कारुणता कारणता अवच्छेदकं प्रतिभागत वैलक्षण्यमेव वा विलक्षण काव्यं प्रति इति न अत्रापि सः अन्वय व्यभिचारः. So there is no anvaya vyabhichara here by saying that, you know, vilakshana kavyam prati vilakshana pratibha eva karanam. In the sense, if that pratibha has come from adrishtam, then adrishta janita pratibha janita kavyam. That's how it goes. And or it should be vyutpatti abhyasa janita pratibha vyutpatti kavyam prati karanam. Then that kavyam which has come about will have that flavor of vyutpatti and abhyasa. Any kavyam which has come from pratibha will have that flavor of pratibha more than vyutpatti or abhyasa. Very clearly, in some cases we can see, like Kalidasa, his vyutpatti or abhyasa does not come to the forefront when we look at Kalidasa's poetry. Whereas when we look at Naishadhakara's poetry, there is an adbhutatvam in it, no doubt. But that vyutpatti and abhyasa will shine, you know, it'll be very apparent for a reader, for an initial reader, that this is like a grammar text. You know, maybe Bhattikavyam is a better example for that, because Ravanavadha, he has specifically written with Vyakaranam in mind. Now, the next case here he takes up is nacha satorapi vyutpatti abhyasayoho yatra na pratibha utpattihi tatra anvaya vyabhicharaha iti vachyam tatra tayoho tadrisha vailakshanye manabhavena karanata avachedaka anavachinnatvat. Now, as always, we first take these separately. This is the Purvapakshi here. सो सतोहो अपि व्युत्पत्ति अभ्यासयोहो व्युत्पत्ति अभ्यासयोहो सतोहो अपि इवन इफ व्युत्पत्ति एंड अभ्यास इज प्रेजेंट इन सर्टेन केसेस न प्रतिभा उत्पत्ति ही वी डू नॉट सी ए प्रतिभा देयर आर मेनी स्कॉलर्स हु हैव स्टडीड संस्कृतम द व्याकरणम एंड एवरीथिंग बट स्टिल दे लैक अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ दैट प्रतिभा which is the karanam hetu for kavyam. They are not able to write a kavyam. Right? There are many people who are very steeped into, they know a lot about the language and everything. They have read a lot of kavyam, yet they are unable to compose a verse or even write a gadya kavyam for that matter. So, satoho api vyutpatti abhyasayoho karanasatve api pratibhayaha utpattihi nasti karya abhavaha इति अन्वय व्यभिचारः अत्र वर्तते. इन सम केसेस दिस इज द पूर्वपक्षी स्मतम इति न च वाच्यम दैट इज योर सिद्धांति. सो सतोहो व्युत्पत्ति अभ्यासयोहो यत्र न प्रतिभा उत्पत्तिः तत्र कारणसत्वे अपि कार्याभावः इति अन्वय व्यभिचारः अस्ति इति पूर्वपक्षिणां मतम् निराकरोति जगन्नाथ पंडितः न च इति न च वाच्यम्. सो तत्र तयोः व्हाट इज हिज आर्ग्युमेंट हियर ही सेज तयोः तादृश वैलक्षण्ये मानाभावेन कारणता अवच्छेदक अनवच्छिन्नत्वात् दैट इज हिज रिप्लाई हियर. तत्र इन प्लेसेस वेयर वी डू नॉट फाइंड दिस प्रतिभा even if vyutpatti and abhyasa is present and pratibha yatra na utpadyate tadrisha sthale tatra tayoho vyutpatti abhyasayoho tadrisha vailakshanye manabhavena. Now here it's tadrisha vailakshanye means प्रतिभा उत्पत्ति अथवा प्रतिभानिष्ठं वैलक्षण्यम् अत्र नास्ति. द वैलक्षण्यम् दट् इस् नेसेसरी फार् ब्रिङ्गिङ्ग् अबौट् दट् प्रतिभा इस् एब्सेण्ट् इन् दट् व्युत्पत्ति अण्ड् अभ्यास दट् इस् बीन् अक्युमुलेटेड् बै दिस् पर्सन् ओवर् सो मेनि इयर्स्. So they have made an exercise and everything, but it has not been tuned towards composing a poetry, or it does not have that extra uniqueness that is necessary for Pratibha, that Anupama or Vailakshanyam, which he says, which is a peculiarity that is absent. That is your Karyata Avachedaka, Vailakshanyam, right? सो कारणता अवच्छेदकं कारणता अवच्छेदक अनवच्छिन्नत्वात् इट् इस् एब्सेण्ट्. नौ दिस् मानाभावेन दट् हि गिव्स् हियर् इस् यु केनाट् गिव् अ प्रमाणं फार् दट् वैलक्षण्यं बिकास् दट् वैलक्षण्यम् इस् अतीन्द्रियं. सो यु केनाट् यु केनाट् प्रूव् इट् बै अनुमानं हियर् आर् यु हेव् टु. There is no way that you can prove by Anumanam, because Anumanam also rests on Pratyaksham. Only if you have seen that in Pratyaksham can you even apply it to Anumanam. So Manabhavena, Tadrisha Vailakshanye Manabhavena. Is that clear? Karanata Avachedaka Anavachinnatvat. So the Pratibha, the Vailakshanya Vyutpatti Abhyasa is not present. Hence, Pratibha was not there, right? And hence kavya utpattihi api na jata. Papa visheshasya tatra pratibandhakatva kalpanadva na doshaha. An alternative is, so I can say you have not, you do not have that peculiar vyutpatti and abhyasa which is necessary for Pratibha, which is necessary for kavya utpatti. The other way to explain it is also, कश्चन पापविशेषः प्रतिबन्धकत्वेन अस्ति एव तत्र. तस्मात् पापविशेषस्य तत्र प्रतिभा अनुत्पत्तिस्थले प्रतिबन्धकत्वकल्पनात् प्रतिबन्धकत्वेन कल्प्यते पापविशेषः. सो देर् ईस् ए पाप सम् सिन् दट् इस् स्टापिङ्ग् यू, दट् ईस् एन् ओब्स्टिकल् इन् प्रतिभा नाट् अरैसिङ्ग् एण्ड् हेन्स् द काव्यं वास् नाट् हेपनिङ्ग्. सो पापविशेषस्य तत्र तादृश व्युत्पत्ति अभ्यासतः प्रतिभा उत्पत्तौ उत्पत्तिस्थले पापविशेषस्य दोषः पापविशेषस्य प्रतिबन्धकत्वकल्पनात् न दोषः व्यभिचारः नास्ति, अन्वयव्यभिचारः नास्ति. वी वर् ओन्ली टाकिङ्ग् अबौट् कारणसत्त्वे अपि कार्य अभावः. सो कारणसत्त्वे अपि कार्याभावे प्रतिबन्धकत्वसत्त्वात् सो नो व्यभिचार प्रतिबन्धक अभावस्य च कारणता समुदित शक्त्यादि त्रय हेतुतावादिनः शक्तिमात्र हेतुतावादिनः च अवशिष्टा. अवशिष्टा समाना. अवशिष्टा मीन्स् इट् इस् तुल्य. अवशिष्टा तुल्य. प्रतिबन्धक अभावः नो यू वाट् इस् द आर्ग्युमेण्ट् आफ् जगन्नाथ पण्डिता हियर्. He said you'll have to look at Pratibha Karanam in two slots. One is either Adrishtam or Vyutpatti Abhyasa. Now you're saying even though Vyutpatti Abhyasa is present in certain people, I do not see a Pratibha, then there could be a Pratibandhakaha, which is some Papa Vishesham, which could be a Pratibandhaka. Now you're again coming back to the point of Adrishtam here. How do you solve that? He says, I don't need to, there is a Gauravam for that. Nanu, tarhi, pratibandhaka adrishta abhavasya karanata kalpanadeva Gauravam ityataha. You're going back to your point of saying that, you know, pratibandhaka is present, then there is an adrishtam there. In Vyutpatti Abhyasa Sthalam also you are talking about an adrishtam here. Then how would it fit? You are also coming back to my point, right? Coming back to the Purupakshi's point. So he is saying, Pratibandhaka Abhavasya cha, the fact that there should not be any obstacle, this condition of obstacle free is common for every paksham, any paksham that you can take. समुदित शक्त्यादि त्रय हेतुतावादिनः शक्तिमात्र हेतुतावादिनः च अवशिष्टा. सो दिस इज कॉमन टू एनी ऑफ द अलंकारिकास दैट यू मे टेक राइट फ्रॉम वामना कुंतक दंडिन. So many of these earlier Alankarikas who have spoken of Shakti Matra Hetuta, that is only Pratibha or Shakti, that Adrishta Vishesham that is present in certain people, which is the reason for Kavya Utpatti. Either those people or Samudita Shakti Adi Traya Hetuta, which is Mammata Adayaha. Mammata etc. have spoken of Shakti Nipunata Abhyasaha. All three are necessary. So samudita shakti iti hetus tadudbhave. In Kavya Prakasha, Mammata says iti hetus tadudbhave, and he talks of three reasons as a set. So samudita shakti adi traya hetuta vadinaha. Those people who argue that shakti, nipunata and abhyasa together, samuditam, is a hetu. Those people and shakti matra hetuta vadinaha, and those purupakshi or alankarikas who talk of only shakti as the hetu, for all of them, it is a common factor that in the karanatva kalpane pratibandhaka abhavaha tu bhavatyeva sarvasyapi. It is तुल्यं सो अवशिष्टा प्रतिबंधक अभावस्य च कारणता फैक्ट दैट प्रतिबंधक अभाव इज ए कारणम इज अवशिष्ट इट इज इक्वल फॉर एवरी मतम वेदर दे एक्सेप्ट शक्ति त्रयम और शक्ति मात्रम. दैट क्लियर. सो विद दिस वन मोर. सो हेतु प्रदर्शनेन उक्तम अर्थम दृढ़यति. Now this pratibandhakam, it just gives an example. Sometimes in some cases, prativadina mantradibhihi krite katipaya divasavyapini vakstambhe vihita aneka prabandhasyapi kavehe kavya anudayasya darshanat. Sometimes, pratividina mantradibhihi krite prativadi, some enemy who is jealous of this kavi, he can use abhichara prayogam mantradibhihi, he can use mantra prabhavena katipaya divasa vyapini vakstambham. He can induce a vakstambha in a kavi. A kavi might have produced many kavyams, and suddenly he finds himself unable to, they say in English it's a writer's block. So he probably feels he's not able to write anything. That the reason for that stopping of that vak prasaraha could be some pratibandhakam, some obstacle, which is an adrishtam. And there is no way to prove that the prativadi has done this abhichara prayoga, this mantra prayoga, right? But it is only with the result that we realize that something like this could have happened, right? Prativadina mantradibhihi krite, when a prativadi or a shatru of another kavi who is jealous of this person or who is angry at this person could have used mantram katipaya divasavyapini vakstambhe, when there is a stop block of his the flow of speech, which is vyapini, which is spread over a few days. Katipaya divasavyapini vihita aneka prabandhasyapi kavehe. Even though the poet has created many prabandha, many works, kavya anudayasya darshanat, suddenly he has lost his capacity to write a poetry. Right? Even without that, some pratibandhakam, even without a prativadi's mantram also, you find that there are certain cases where no shloka will come out. You might be writing, suddenly there will be a spate of writing, and then suddenly he doesn't write. It is possible. So that pratibandhaka abhava is common to all matam here. So with this he concludes the pratibha discussion, and now he starts his division of kavya. So tatcha इत्थं काव्यस्य कारणं निरूप्य प्रकारान् व्याहरति हि डिवाइड्स इट इनटू फोर तच्च काव्यं च उत्तमोत्तम इज वन उत्तमोत्तमम् उत्तम उत्तमम् इज द सेकंड कैटेगरी मध्यमम् थर्ड कैटेगरी अधमम् अधम भेदात् चतुर्धा सो देयर आर फोर कैटेगरीज जनरली काव्य प्रकाश और काव्य प्रकाशकार सेज एक्सेप्ट्स three varieties, which is Uttama, Madhyama and Adhama. So Dhvani, Gunibhutam and Chitrakavyam, that is his divisions. If you look at Vishwanatha in Sahitya Darpanam, he talks of only two, Uttama and Madhyama, that is Dhvanikavyam and Gunibhutam. He does not accept Chitrakavyam at all. If it is Adhamam, then I don't even need to take it into this category. Now here Jagannatha Pandita says Uttamottama, Uttama, Madhyama and Adhama. Now he will establish why these four varieties are needed and he is going to give Lakshanam and Udaharanam for all of these. So the Prathama Prakaram, Shabdarthau Yatra Guni Bhavita Atmanau Kamapi Artham Abhivyantaha Tadadhyam. Tadadhyam. आद्यं काव्यं उत्तमोत्तमं काव्यं यत्र यत्र यस्मिन् काव्ये शब्दार्थौ शब्दः वाचकः शब्दः अर्थः वाच्यार्थः ओके सो द प्राइमरी मीनिंग एंड द प्राइमरी वर्ड शब्दार्थौ गुणीभवित आत्मानौ दे बिकम व्यंग्यार्थ अपेक्षया अप्रधानीकृत स्वरूपौ सो द लिटररी मीनिंग गिव्स राइज टू अ सजेशन And when you, with regards to the suggestive meaning, these two, Shabda and Artha, the literary word and the literary meaning, become apradhanam, gunibhutam. Gunibhutam means apradhanam or secondary. So, Shabdarthau, yatra gunibhavita atmanau, where they have become apradhanam or secondary. And kamapi artham abhivyantaha. Not only are they secondary, it also gives rise to kamapi abhivya. Kamapi, wherever you use kamapi, kapi, kimapi, it indicates anirvachaniyam athava chamatkara atishayam. So kamapi chamatkara atishaya adhanena anirvachaniyam pradhanam artham abhivyankpaha abhivyanakti abhivyanktaha. Vivachanam. So where a word and meaning become secondary or make themselves secondary and suggest abhivyanakti and suggest some anirvachaniya, something beautiful, a beautiful meaning, that kavyam is called uttamottama kavyam. Very clearly it seems to follow the same thing that Mammata says. He will establish that Uttamottama Kavyam is different from Uttama Kavyam. We can see how later. Just to give an idea, the same Gunibhuta, Gunibhavita Atmanau Kamapi Artham Abhivyantaha, this Lakshanam follows Dhvanikara's Lakshanam. Tathacha Dhvanigrante Yatrartha Shabdova Tamartham Upasarjani Krita Swarthau Vyantak Kavya Visheshaha Sadhvaniriti Suribhik Katitaha. It is the same words from Dhunyaloka that Rasagangadhara also takes. So, yatra yasmin kavye, artaha shabdahava, upasarjani krita swarthau, sva artham, sva artha is prayojanam here. The effect of it becomes upasarjani kritam, guni bhutam, apradhani kritam, all are synonymous words. Paryaya vachi shabdaha. उपसर्जनीकृत स्वार्थौ तम अर्थम व्यंक्तः एंड दे आल्सो गिव राइज टू दैट आइदर द शब्द और द अर्थ गिव्स राइज टू ए अनदर व्यंग्यार्थ ए सजेस्टेड मीनिंग सह काव्य विशेषः ध्वनिः इति सूरिभिः कथितः दैट अलोन इज कॉल्ड ध्वनि Suribihi, here he says, is a Prathamohi Vidvamsaha Vayyakarana, Prathamehi Vidvamsaha Vayyakaranaha. And Suri, according to Anandavardhana Abhinogupta, it is Vaiyakarana, who have given us the concept of dhvani and that vyangyartha, their concept of dhvani is based on the alankarika concept of dhvani has come from the spota concept of vyakarana. But the swarupam of spota is very different from the dhvani swarupam or the definition of dhvani that we give in alankara shastra. Okay. Now he again analyzes why he has given these words guni bhavita atmano and kamapi artham abhivyantaha. These are the two points that he takes up to distinguish between the guni bhuta vyangyam and the uttamottama kavyam. So kamapi iti chamatkriti bhumim. Chamatkriti bhumihi ashrayaha. Chamatkriti ashrayaha. Kamapi anirvachaniyam. Kamapi indicates something. So when we say something, it means something that is indescribable, right? So kamapi iti chamatkriti bhumim. It has a beauty in it. Hence, tena atigudha sputavyangayoho nirasaha. Now, there are a couple of gunibhuta vyangyam that he says here. These are all technical terms. When you look at atigudha and sputavyangya, aparanga, vachya siddhyanga, these four are four types of gunibhuta vyangyam. There are four more types, but with atiguda and sputa vyangyam, he has also indicated asundaram here, which is another type of gunibhuta vyangyam, which is a madhyama kavyam. And then with aparangam, he has also indicated sandigda pradhanya, tulya pradhanya, kakvakshiptam. Yes. So eight are here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are totally eight varieties of gunibhuta vyangyam which Mammata has said in Kavya Prakasham in the fifth Ullasa. Rasagangadharakara Jagannatha Pandita does not explain, give us the different varieties of gunibhuta vyangyam in the first chapter. I have not looked at the second chapter. It could be in the second chapter. I'm not sure about that. But we will take it that he is. I wanted to show some examples from Kavya Prakasha so that we understand what he means by this. See, Atigudham and Sputavyangyam are two varieties where the Vyangyartha is not. It should. Atigudham is where the Vyangyartha is not clear. Sputavyangyam is where the suggested meaning is very, very clear. If the suggested meaning is extremely clear, then there is no chamatkriti in it. There is no beauty in it. You'll have to search for it. At the same time, you will feel like searching for it. You will look for where it is. What is he trying to say? You know, at the same time, it should not be totally covered. Ati gudham ittyapi na bhavitavya. Right? In Tamil, we say, you know, yala maraivu kai maraivu. It's like on a tree. In a mango tree, you know, you always feel the mango which is half hidden is much bigger than the mango that is fully seen. If it is completely hidden, you are not going to think about it at all because you don't see it. Whereas the mango which is completely seen, we know the size of it, we have seen it. But the mango that is half hidden is always more attractive because we feel maybe the hidden part is bigger than what we see outside and probably it is more sweet and all that. So there is a ruchi in something which is half hidden and half exposed. So that is the idea of vyangyartham. The suggested meaning should always be in such a way that it is not very, very clear, nor is it extremely hidden. It should be half revealing and so you will keep going into it. That is when it will give rise to charvana. You will keep anusandhanam. You will keep thinking about it again and again. No, that is where that swarasthyam comes about. That rasikata for a poetry comes from that anusandhanam. It is not just reading once and, I like the shloka and you go away. No, you go back to it again and again. Why do you keep going back to something like that abhanubhedyam, aratna alokam tamaha, yavvana madaha? So you want to go back to it because he is trying to give, there is something hidden there that he is trying to tell us. The ashakyata of, it is very difficult to remove that yavvana madaha from our mind. anybody who is in that Yavvanam, it's very difficult for them. That dridhata that is there for that Yavvanam in our mind is very clearly shown there. And you also want to keep on thinking about it again and again. That is that dhvani, the attraction of Vyangyam is that. So kamapi iti chamatkriti bhumim tena atigudha sputavyangyayoho nirasaha. I just took some examples for that atigudam to show how it is very different from this thing. This is an example from Kavyaprakasha. So adrishte darshanotkantha drishte vichedabiruta na adrishtena na drishtena bhavata labhyate sukham. This is an example for atigudam, which is a gunibhuta vyangyam in Kavyaprakasha. So the shloka meaning goes like this. Adrishte kashchana nayakaha nayikam prati nayika vishaye vadati. Adrishte sa, when I don't see her, darshana utkanta. This is about a nayika talking about a nayaka. Nayaka vishaye nayika vadati. Right? Ama. Adrishte darshana utkanta. Adrishte. Yeda nayake adrishte sati darshana utkantha. There is a eagerness to see him when he is not there. Drishte, when I see the nayaka, vichheda biruta, I'm afraid of separation from him. Adrishtena na adrishtena na drishtena bhavata labhyate sukham. So I have no happiness whether I see you or don't see you. Now here, what is she trying to convey? The Vyangyartham is completely lost here. You only look at the Vachyartham here. So when I see you, I'm afraid. When I see you, I'm afraid of the separation. When I don't see you, I want to see you, and that longing creates a suffering in my mind. Now, whether I see you or not, there is a suffering in my mind. Natu sukham tatra asti adrishtena drishtena va sukham naiva vidyate. तरी व्यंग्यार्थः अत्र अदृष्टः यथा न भवसि यथा वियोगभयं च न उत्पद्यते तथा कुर्याः इति नायकं प्रति प्रार्थना. सो यू हैव टू बिहेव इन सच अ मैनर दैट व्हेन आई सी यू आई शुड यू शुड गिव मी रीअश्योरेंस दैट यू विल नॉट गो अवे फ्रॉम मी व्हेन आई And ensure that you are never separated from me. So that is the Vyangyartha that we are trying to portray here, which is too hidden among this drishta, adrishta, na drishta, adrishta, and all that, na drishtam, na adrishtam, and all that. Right? So this is an example of atigudham, where the Vyangyartha has no chamatkriti, the Vachyartha has more chamatkriti. And the Vyangyartham is actually totally hidden that we can't even get it without the Vyakhyata's help, without the commentator. We can't even understand what the Vyangyartham is here. Half the time, even if it is putam, we don't understand. That's a different matter. So the next one is putam. If the Vyangyartha is very clear, even there, it is not going to be a dhvani because there is no chamatkriti. There is no chamatkaraha. There's no beauty in it. So, yasya asuhrit krita tiraskritihi etya tapta suchi vyadha vyatikarena yunakti karnau kanchi guna grathana bhajanam eshaha saha asmi jivanna nasamprati bhavami kimavahami. This is an example. This is a shloka supposedly said by Brihannala, Arjuna, who was... who had taken up the dance master, the task of a dance master, and Brihannala, right? So he, during that time, the enemies are attacking asuhrit shatru. So shatru krita tiraskritihi etya, after attaining that, I think it is the tiraskriti metya. Maybe I'm wrong here. Okay, so yasya karnau, tapta suchi vyadha vyatikarena yunakti. When I hear about what the enemies have done to us, the humiliation that we have suffered under the hands of the enemy, it is like someone who is piercing my ears with a heated needle. It is a type of thing. So, tapta suchi vyadha vyatikarena karnau yunakti. It is that humiliation is like piercing the ears with a heated needle, hot needle, tapta suchi. Kanchi gunagrathana bhajanam eshaha. Now, how is Arjuna here? He has Kanchi gunam. Kanchi gunam is the hip chain that he is wearing, which is which ladies wear, right? So he is in the garb of a dance master, and so he is wearing Kanchi guna grathana bhajanam eshaha saha asmi jivan na bhavami. I am living, but I am not. Jivan napi na bhavami samprati kim avahami. What can I do now? Even though I'm living, I'm not there. So that itself shows us the frustration that he must be going at that point of time. He cannot reveal himself. He is Brihannala there. So he cannot suddenly take up his Gandivam and do it, because they are bound by that 13 years, that 1 year of Ajnatavasam time. So he says, Jeevannapi Nabhavami. You have the Mukhyartha Bhada there. So kashta jivanatvam, I'm going through such a bad time that I cannot, Arjuna is such a person who cannot tolerate this revenge, and he has to immediately show his prowess. He's such a great parakrami. So that jivanapi na bhavami, even though I'm living, it is equal to not living, which means maranameva shreyaha. That is your vengyartha here, which is very clear. As soon as you hear that, you know, tapta suchi vyadha vyatikarena yunakti karnau jivannapi na bhavami. Even though I am living, it is like, we say nadaipanam in Tamil. It's like walking corpse. He feels like he is one. Jivannapi na bhavami. That's the idea we get as soon as we understand the context and the meaning of the shloka. So here also, there is no chamatkriti. Maranameva shreyaha iti vyangyarthe kutra chamatkriti hi asti. The way he says it, jivannapi na bhavami, is more beautiful than saying, let me die. You know, committing suicide is not a great vyangyartha here. Whereas that jivannapi bhavami, kim avahami, what can I possibly achieve in this state? Kanchi guna grathana bhajanam yeshaha. And that is more beautiful than the vyangyartha. So that chamatkriti, if that chamatkriti is absent, then kamapi iti chamatkriti bhumim tena atiguda sputavyangyayoho nirasaha. In the lakshanam, because he has added kamapi artham abhivyangtaha, this lakshanam will not pervade the guni bhuta vyangya also. So we have removed that from this lakshanam. The next is aparangam and vachya sindhyanga vyangyasyapi chamatkaritaya. Now there are certain varieties of guni bhuta vyangyam where the vyangyartha is beautiful. See, there can be, not every shlokam in a huge kavyam will have all shlokas as dhvani, unnecessary. When I start with Kumarasambhava, Astyuttarasyam, Dishidevatatma, Himalayonamanakadiraja, Purvaparavvarini Dhivagahya, Sthitapritivya, Ivamanada. What is the big vyangyartha there? Nothing, we are just describing. There is a mountain in the north direction. He is so huge that he enters the two samudram on both sides. And he is as if it's like a ruler, you know, a standard measurement for how wide the earth is. That's all the shloka says. There is no dhvani as such beautifully there. So there are many such shlokas which do not have chamatkaram. That is one thing. There are other shlokas which may not be rasadhvani always, which may not we give you an alankaradhvani, which may not give you a vastudhvani, but it may have some beautiful meaning that it gives. Or there can be a rasa which is given, but there can be two rasas, and one rasa can be an angam for the other rasa. So when you look at the anga rasa, that rasa may not be so beautifully expressed and it becomes vachyam, and that is more beautiful than the karunam, which is probably the vyangyartha. So then one rasa becomes the angam for another rasa. These, even these can be considered as gunibhuta vyangyam. So they have chamatkara. That is where he says guni bhavita atmanau iti swa apekshaya vyangya pradhanyam abhiprayakam. So in these varieties of gunibhuta vyangyam, like aparangam and vachyasiddhyangam, or even sandigdha pradhanyam, tulya pradhanyam, kakva kshiptam, all these varieties also, you have the vyangyartha is beautiful. Maybe in Atigudam and Sputam, the two examples that we saw now, there is no beauty in the Vingyartha. The Vachyartham is more beautiful. So we say, Kamapi Chamatkriti, Chamatkaraha Arthaha Tatra Vyajyate, Yatra Vyajyate, Tatraiva Uttamottama Kavyam, Iti Vaktum Shakyate. But in places where the Vingyarthaha Chamatkara Purvakaha Eva, then what do we say? For that, he uses the word guni bhavita atmanav. Guni bhavita atmanav. Huh? Guni bhavita atmanav. Both are right. Guni bhavitam. Guni bhavitam is right. They make themselves as apradhanam with respect to the vengyartha. Okay? So, an example for this aparasyangam is in the Bhurishravas is a character in Mahabharata where he is dead, his hand has been chopped off, and his wives are looking at that hand and they are remembering the way they had a Shringara with him before. So it is actually Karuna Rasam, which is the context. And they're describing that hand. Ayam sa rashanotkarshi peenastana vimardhanaha nabhyuru jaganasparshi nivi visramsanaha karaha. So this is the hand that had touched us. So they are remembering that Shringara which was there before, but it is actually angam to the karunam, which is the prasanga here. So the karuna becomes the prasanga. When you look at the whole context and the whole text, Karuna Rasam, because Bhurishravas, who is the Alambana Vibhava, is no more. And these ladies are looking at him and they are crying. And that lament increases the Karuna Rasa in the mind of the readers. So when you look at it from the aspect of Karuna Rasam, it is a Dhvanikavya. Whereas when you look at it from the aspect of Shringara Rasam, the Shringara becomes an Angabhutam for Karuna. Aparasya Angam Yatra Ekaha Rasaha Aparasya Bhavasya Atava Rasasya Atava Bhavadvane Bhavasandhi Bhavashabalata. There are so many things that can be there. If a rasa becomes a subordinate to something else, that is any place of Rasavadalankara, there it is called Aparangam, which is a Gunibhuta Vyangya, which is a Madhyama Kavyam, supposedly. So this is an example for Aparangam. Even though that Karuna Rasam, which is Vyangya, is beautiful, or the Shringaram, which is Vyangyam, which is beautiful. Actually, the Shringaram is Vachyam here. It is only the Karunam is beautiful. But the Shringara becomes more beautiful as it increases the karunam for the in the context. The next one is vachyasiddhyangam. Here also the vyangyartha is beautiful. Deepayan rodasi randhram esha jvalati sarvataha pratapaha tava rajendra vairi vamsha davanalaha. Now hey Rajendra, a kavi is addressing a king and saying, hey Rajendra, tava pratapaha sarvataha jvalati, your parakramam, your viratvam, your tejas is lighting up the entire world. Deepayan vairi vamsha davanalaha, it is actually an agni. Your pratapam is like an agni which destroys the vairi vamsha, the shatru kulam. The vachyartham here is rajnyaha pratapaha davanalaha. It is just used in a samanadhikaranyam here, like a rupakalankaram. Right? So pratape दवानलत्व दवाग्नेहे आरोपः क्रियते अत्र इट इज द वाच्यार्थम हियर इफ यू लुक एट द वर्ड वंश देयर आर टू मीनिंग्स फॉर दैट वर्ड वंश वंश मीन्स कुलम एनदर मीनिंग ऑफ इट आल्सो इज बैंबू वेणु वंश आल्सो मीन्स वेणु बट द शत्रु कुलम एव वेणुः दैट पार्ट इज योर व्यंग्यार्थ It is like a bamboo and this king's pratapam is capable of completely destroying, you know, just like how fire can completely destroy a bamboo forest, in the same manner this king can also destroy the enemy's kulam, entire family. So that, the if I have to, how can I equate pratapa with agni without any indhanam? We need an indhanam for the agni. But the indhanam here, the double meaning for vamsha, by prakaranam we fix the meaning of the word vamsha as kulam. And the vyangyartham becomes the venu. For this davanala to, for us to fix the meaning of pratapa as davanala, davagni, we need the meaning of venu, for this to become clear, right? So the Vyangyartha actually supports the Vachyartha here, and Vachya Siddhyartham Angam Bhavati Vyangyartha. So the Vyangyartha becomes a support for the Vachyartham, right? Even if it is more beautiful, even if it is beautiful, still it becomes a support for the Vachyam. And the Vachya, we come back to the Vachyartha. We don't just treat the Vachyartha separately from the Vyangyartha, and like Gato Astamarkaha, where we say, you know, there are so many different Vyangyarthas that can come about. When I say Gato Astamarkaha, the sun has set. Each person has different meanings. None of those meanings, we don't come back to the point that, oh, the sun has set. No, we always keep thinking about the Vyangyartha that comes out of that sentence, Vachyartha. That is dhvanisthalam. Whereas here in Vachya Siddhyangam, we keep coming back to the Vachyartham. We use that Vengyartha to support the Vachyartha. Right? So here the Shabdarthau have not become Gunibhutam. They have not become Apradhanam. Instead, they are Pradhana here. Okay? So Aparanga, Vachya Siddhyanga Vyangyasyapi, Chamatkaritaya, even though there is a beauty in the Vyangyartha in these types of Gunibhuta Vyangyam. Tadvaranaya Gunibhavita Atmano Shabdartho iti Visheshanam Prayujyate. Sva Apekshaya Shabdartha Apekshaya. Right? Apekshaya Vyangya Pradhanya Abhiprayakam. Vyangyam takes on a Mukhyatvam there. Okay?